Hi there, it is Karen Goodman with Arch City Homes and Circa Properties. And I am driving, and yes, I know I'm driving and I'm videoing, but I'm not holding the phone. So if I hit a bump and you fall on the floor, that's why I have this magnetic mounted stand thing. And that keeps the phone in place, but when I hit bumps, the phone sometimes crashes to the floor. So I need to fix that. So anyway, I thought while I was driving home from a very, very long day, I could share with you a little bit about a day in the life of a real estate agent, because I think so many people just assume that we spend our days just showing homes and meeting new clients and closing on deals, and all of that happens, but there's a lot of other stuff that happens too. And so I thought I would just share a little bit about what day in the life of a real estate agent is like. So bear with me while I do a little safe merging. Okay, yes, I know I'm driving and videoing, so don't yell at me, I'm being careful, and which is why I'm not looking at the camera. So my day started really early. Yes, being a real estate agent means you don't have to go into an office. Nobody is expecting you to show up at a particular time. Nobody is watching the clock. So I got started about 7:30 this morning. I went and made some coffee and let the dog out and fed him. Didn't even get dressed and opened the computer, started working on catching up on emails, checking voicemails that I had missed, things like that. And then, let's see, what did I do? So first thing, I started working on a listing. I've got a new listing in Webster Groves, 509 Lark Hill. It's gonna be open, I'm gonna probably get that on the market tonight, live in the MLS. And so I was working on that this morning, and I was working on what information do I still need from the sellers so that I can finish up that listing, sending them information, letting them see the pictures, those kinds of things. So I was working on that, and then I was also trying to do a little prep work this morning for a listing appointment that I had today. So I needed to do a little bit of prep work there to be ready for that appointment. And then also, I'm just now coming from a final walkthrough. We're closing in the morning, so I needed to kind of pull up all the information. So I had all the repairs. I knew everything that was supposed to happen. I was reviewing everything and realized there were a couple of things we didn't have documentation on for. So I reached out to my assistant and gave her instructions on what she needed to do. Oh, there goes the phone. We're back. So I did that, got an interruption, which happens all the time in real estate. My accountant called, who happens to be my sister, she's great, and she called to let me know my taxes and how much money I owe. I had a really, really great year last year, 2015, compared to 2014. So that's wonderful, right? Well, it also means that I owe a ton of money. So I had to actually she actually had to check with my financial planner and make sure that like figure out, like, did I have enough money to do all this stuff? So that kind of interrupted my morning. Straightened all that out. again, life, day in the life of a realtor. excuse me. so I put some sod in a while ago, and it kind of ended up bumpy. So I have my contractor is coming back tomorrow. Excuse me, I'm gonna find some water to smash it down a little bit more and make sure that it's level and it's not bumpy and it's not a trip hazard. Trip hazard is a language that I learned from home inspectors. You really don't want to have trip hazards in your house. So I had talked to my neighbor behind me that said, I told him I needed to borrow a sprinkler. So he brought it over to show me how to use it. I was all dressed and ready to go, and he showed me what I was doing. I zipped out really quick, headed to a meeting with my referral team, a lunch meeting. So spent a couple of hours or an hour and a half with them. Also connected with a couple of people that I needed to do some business with. Then what was next? I had about 15 minutes and I had an email that absolutely had to go out to my marketing coordinator in order to have my marketing information package ready for this open house on Sunday. I had a hard and fast deadline of 5 p.m. today, and I just had been slammed, and so I was like, I gotta make this deadline. So I literally found a spot. I had 15 minutes in my day. I sat down, I wrote an email, shot that out. I borrowed Daily Bread's outside patio table and borrowed the next door Wi-Fi so I could do it. Then I looked at my clock and realized I had 15 minutes to get to my listing appointment, so I stopped that and I headed to the listing appointment for this potential new client in Kirkwood, and spent an hour and a half or so with them, walking around the house, talking with them about their house, you know, what are some things that we need to consider, what are some things, steps they need to take, things like that. So left with a to-do list for them. Walked out their door, glanced at my phone, and the timing was perfect. I had just enough time to get to my walkthrough. So I went from Kirkwood, so the meeting was in Brentwood, then I went to Kirkwood for the listing appointment, then I drove out to St. Charles near the 370 bridge, so the northern part of St. Charles, so that I could do a final walkthrough with some clients, Rob and PK, who are closing on a house in the morning. So got there, we walked through the house, we checked everything was great. A couple of questions that needed to be resolved. I'm holding the phone again. Hold on as I turn. There we go. Oops. Let me put it back so it doesn't fall. Okay. Trust that it doesn't fall. So walk through, figured out what we need to do, got in the car, realized that the email that had to make that deadline had not somehow sent. So I was driving and trying to, when I was hitting stoplights, trying to carefully like check my outbox and couldn't find it. So I was texting while driving, but I was doing it by voice. I wasn't typing. And I was trying to figure out with my marketing director if he had gotten it and when, you know, how was I gonna get it to him. And I did manage to figure out that I had accidentally, when I thought I had hit send, I actually hit delete. So I was able to forward it to him, I think he has it. As soon as I get home, I'm gonna check and make sure he really does have it. I'm gonna hold the phone for a second because this road is really bumpy. So that's where we're at. So at this point it is 6 p.m. I am finally on my way home. When I get home, I need to make sure that email went out that had to go out an hour ago. Then I need to deal with my yard so I can start soaking my sod. And then I will sit down and probably do about another 2 or 3 hours worth of work tonight. Following up on some things, getting that new listing live in the MLS. What else? I'm not sure. Dealing with whatever crises come up. And then I'll probably stop somewhere around 9. It's pretty typical. So for people that think that, you know, being in real estate is really easy, it is sometimes. And then there are days like today where I literally started at 7:30 a.m. I worked through lunch. I'll work through dinner. And I'll quit at like 9 p.m. And that's just kind of how it goes with real estate. Hang on. I'm pulling into I'm now home. It's 6:06 according to my car. Put this back here for a second. So that's the day in the life. So it is, you know, it's fun. I love real estate. I love that I was out and about and running all over and fielding all these crazy things. And tomorrow will be completely different than today was, and which is totally different than yesterday was. I love that. But there definitely are days where, you know, it's a long day. And you have to, you know, it's not like a regular job where, you know, you get off at 5 or 5:30 or whatever time and you get to go home. and, you know, you're off. You know, you've, you know, it's not punching a clock, but, you know, they, you know, they don't expect you to work in the evening. No, a lot of people, there are things you have to do in the evening. But being in real estate is basically owning your own business. So you have to get it done somehow. You know, it has to get done. It doesn't matter. Your clients expect you to get it done. And so you do whatever it takes to get it done, so that you can meet the obligation that you've set out to them. And then mixed in with them, you've got to find time to like find new business. And then you've got to talk to your accountant. And then you've got to talk to your assistant about things you need to do and managing the paperwork and the administration stuff of the job. So there's a lot more than just selling homes and showing up on closing day and showing buyers homes and, you know, looking at decorating and stuff. There's a lot more to it. So I love what I do. I think it's a great profession for people that want to kind of be in control of their own destiny and their own life. You know, but you got to be willing to do whatever it takes. So anyway, that's a day in the life of a real estate agent. My dog is sitting in the window looking at me. It's time for me to head in, go feed him, soak the sod, deal with that email, get the MLS listing live, and about, you know, a dozen other things. So I will catch you later. I'm going to be doing more of these Facebook Live things to show you what's going on and to keep in touch. And I will catch you around next time. Bye-bye.